Hello everyone. In this video, we will present to you the new features for our combined charging system, or CCS, testing solution with ISO 15118 communication protocol components in Typhoon HIL Control Center 2022.4. New features were added to the supply equipment charge controller and the electric vehicle charging controller components that allow for full coverage of CCS test cases involving AC and DC charging. Support is also extended to cover ISO 15118-3 power line communication with the signal level attenuation and characterization protocol. ISO 15118-2 is a vehicle-to-grid protocol supporting AC and DC charging in the same connector. It is mapped as a high-level communication protocol for combined charging systems inside the Global Standard for Electric Vehicle Charging, IEC 61851. This protocol allows DC fast charging and adds an extra layer of security, making the charging process safer for both the user and the energy distributor. In previous releases, the EVCC component only had support for DC charging, and the SECC component only had support for AC charging. Now, EVCC and SECC supports both AC and DC charging, which makes it possible to simulate an electric vehicle or a charging station and perform full testing cases for all the energy transfer modes covered by the CCS standard. Let's open Schematic Editor to show the new features for the ISO 15118 in Typhoon HIL Control Center. In this model, it is possible to see the SECC and EVCC components in the same schematic. This lets you have a complete ISO 15118-2 simulation inside parallel Typhoon HIL devices. It is important to note that it is not possible to simulate both components in the same HIL device, so performing these tests requires a multi-HIL setup. Let's start by opening the component properties of the SECC. In the option medium type, it is possible to select Ethernet or power line communication, depending on what physical layer you want to access with the ISO 15118-2 protocol. In the supported energy mode section, it is now possible to select all DC charging modes, as well as combine multiple modes together with AC charging modes, like in a universal charger. Depending on which mode is selected, the station parameters dialog box changes accordingly. Now, let's see the EVCC component changes by opening its properties. Like in the SECC component, it is possible to select either Ethernet or power line communication as the medium type. In the energy transfer mode, one can select between multiple modes, including AC and DC charging modes. For the EVCC component, only one mode at a time is allowed. For this demonstration, let's choose DC charging energy transfer modes and compile and run the simulation. This SCADA panel is divided in two parts. On the left side, we have the charger station panel and on the right side, the electric vehicle panel. After we start the simulation and change the inlet status from disconnected to connected, the charging process should start automatically. Now it is possible to see the charging process, as well as the messages exchanged between the SECC and EVCC by looking at the charging controller widgets. With this demonstration, we conclude our presentation with the new features that allow for full test coverage of ISO 15118-2 using Typhoon HIL Control Center 2022.4. Please feel free to review our other tutorials on ISO 15118 for more examples of what you can do with these components. Thank you for watching.